Hello everyone, welcome to this new tutorial. It's been a while. Meanwhile, I've had a celebration of 5,000 followers on Instagram, which is awesome, of course. So thanks to all my followers for making this possible. And the tutorial of today is going to be this pop-up hot air balloon. As you can see, it has all these nice curved shapes and it pulls the balloon into shape, so these curves happen. A very nice way to make something organic. I also have a colored version here, which looks like this. And as you can see, there's so much you can do with just the steam, and it really pops up like an inflated balloon. So that's what we're going to do today. I have a template. You can find the link in the description of this video. It contains 6 pages. This is a page with the folding guide. I recommend to use this. And there are some tips and tricks on this. The sort of paper that you can use for this project. I like to use 80 LB paper. There's ticks and trips, materials you'll need, and of course the template files. I've also added this sheet that you can print out for adding extra decoration. As you can see, I've used some of these for the colored pop-up. Right, so you can decide yourself how to decorate it. I choose to not use the sun, but it's also a nice addition to this pop-up. And you can print this out. You don't need to print out all the pages because some are just information. But for this build, we're going to use the elements of the pop-up, the base plate, and some decorations. So that's like 3 pages you need to print out. So first things first, and we will have to prepare these parts and make scoring lines. Before I start, I would like to show what tools I'm going to use for this project. First of all, I'm using a knife, 2 kinds of knives, one for straight lines, one for precision cutting. Be very careful with those. Also, if you're doing this with a kit, you can maybe better use scissors, like so. For scoring lines, I use this pen. It has a blunt tip, but you can also use a paperclip for scoring lines next to a ruler. An empty pen like this one, which is not empty, but it doesn't matter. Or a dining knife. The backside also is very useful to make scoring lines. So I'm using my pen. I'm also using a ruler and a precision, a geometric triangle, sorry. And if you're not sure what to use, I use double-sided tape. But you can use glue if you have that. I prefer this, but maybe glue is better for colored paper. That's up to you. So first things first, let's get started with scoring the lines for this pop-up. And therefore I have this scoring guide that you can use to mark lines that you've already scored. And these parts have little triangles. You'll have to connect those. Looks like a lot of work, but as you will see, it's pretty easy and straightforward. So I'm going to start with that. Let me start with this top piece. So I'm connecting the triangles from here till here. I do the same on this side. Like so. This is a longer line, so I'm going to use my ruler for that. So I need to connect this triangle with that triangle. And if you follow my steps very carefully, you'll see that this isn't a hard pop-up to make, but it's important to follow the details and to be very precise for it to work. But that's the case with most pop-ups. So I've already done 2 parts. This one is a bit tricky. It has 2 diagonal lines. So I'll start with this one first. like so. And this one, like so. And scoring these lines takes about a couple of minutes, and you're good to go. Like so. So if you count with me, 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, and you can mark that here, 1, 2, 3, 4. This will help you to make sure you've done everything right. So one more here. Again, this part also has 2 diagonals, so make sure to do that very precise. And there's some guidelines here, so you can double check if the scoring aligns with the guidelines. I'll show this up close. So it should look like this. While doing this, I make sure to put some pressure on the pen, but not too much. It's not good to damage the paper, of course. One here, already did that. So that's it, ready scoring. Now the next step is going to be cutting out all these pieces. No, I'm forgetting one important step, because we're scoring the folding lines. That's the base page. There are tiny marks here, this line and that line. So again, I'm going to use my ruler. Make sure to score that line very precise. And when you did it right, you'll see that the line is just above this square that says A. I can already fold this. And as you can see, it's not a cover that completely closes, but that's also because it makes it easier to work inside the pop-up. And we will add a fitting cover later, so don't worry about that. Next step, I'm going to cut out all these pieces. That's very straightforward, but also boring to watch. So I'm going to cut these out, and we'll come back to you later when I'm finished with this. I've cut out all the pieces, and we can set these aside so we can start building the pop-up piece by piece. And the first piece we are going to use is this one. This is going to be the piece that holds the part that pulls the balloon. So I need to fold these over, like so. And when I get the base page, you will see C and D. That refers to these tabs, and I can glue it on like so. So I'm going to use tape for this. And again, of course, you can also use glue. I like to work with tape on white paper, and maybe some colored paper is better to use glue for some types of paper, because tape can get loose. Here's the different another part. I'll have to fold this over. This is going to be a double layer to make it extra strong. So I'm putting tape on this side. Fold it over. You'll get something like this. You also need to fold over the B tab and the A tab. And as you can see, this refers to this glue point. So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to tape it on there. And before I do that, I make sure to get this part through this part very carefully. And that just fits perfect. I'm going to very carefully, it's important to do this precise, like so. This part, now we have this motion in the pop-up, and this part should pull this, let me get it, this part. So that's going to be the next step. I'm going to prepare this. And because all parts are symmetrical, you can also choose to use parts with the printed side downwards. So you won't have any letters on your work. As you can see, I can show you with this one. Let me get it here. These letters, you can prevent this by using the back side of the piece. So that's what I'm going to do now. So I need to first get some tape on this tab. I'm going to tape it down here. Also again, do this very precise. Like so. And now we need to glue down the B part. And therefore I'm going to close the card. Keep this flat and fold this one over. And as you can see, it now pulls that part. Not really, I can do this better. Hold on a second. So, very carefully. Needs to be a bit more straight. All right. I think that's much better, yes. This is important because it needs to move symmetrical. Now we have this. Next part is going to be this one. So you start with flipping over this E-tab. And I like to do this like this. First in the middle. And you need to be very careful with this. Fold this in. Like so, and do the same on this side. Like so. And this E part should be glued on top of this E. Makes sense. I'm going to do that. I'm doing this a bit quickly for the video, but you'll understand that you can take all the time you need to do this very precise. Probably this will turn out a bit rough, but I'm sure it will work. Okay, that's that. Now we have this prepared for the balloon parts, which is going to be a precise job. Again, you can choose to have the printed side on top. Have to make sure this looks good. All right. But when you flip it around, you can use it without the printed letter on top. So it's going to be this way or that way. All right. I didn't mark these parts, and this is what we're going to use to glue on the balloon, because it's a very small part to glue on. And I don't want your ink printer ink to be a factor, so it doesn't glue firmly enough. So just be sure that you're doing this right. It looks like this. I'm going to do the same on the other side. So what I do, I fold a little triangle out of tape, like so, and I put it here. Make sure to not put tape over the fold. That's very important, or it won't work. As you can see, that's the part I put tape on. And I'm going to align this point straight to this fold here. I hope this is very clear, but you'll have to do it to understand, I guess. So another thing that's important, I'll have to get this off carefully, is that they won't overlap when folded in. So when you look at this, there's no overlapping. That's important. All right. Next, we're going to attach these tabs. So therefore, I have to fold the card close, shut, and I'm going to apply some tape on these parts. Those are marked with K and J. Oh, it's not clear to see. There you go. JK. And to do this correct, I need to fold over the tab. Put on a little tape. And put down this part of the balloon. It should look something like this. I'm going to do the same with this one. So I'm putting tape on the back, like so. And then fold it flat and make sure that part is connected to it. If you open it now, as you can see, there's already some curves that come into shape. So last step for the balloon is to add the centerpiece. And I have to fold this, like so. All right. Again, I wanna have the letters on the downside. Didn't cut this really straight, but doesn't matter. So I'm first going to put some tape on the eye. Like so. Just the square part, not the whole piece. And I'm going to shut the card. Hold this back a little so I can see what I'm doing. And make sure this tip is aligning with this tip and it's centered. And that looks nice, nice enough. So as you can see, it now is centered in the middle. Now this part needs to be connected to this part. Therefore, I'm going to put some tape on the G. I'm going to close the card and fold this over. And push it down so the tape sticks. And it should look something like this. All right. So what we have now is this balloon part. Pretty simple, straightforward to do, I think. Now we're going to make the basket and we'll use this part for it. So I'm going to fold all the scoring lines. And I'll need to glue this to that, and therefore I'll have to keep it like so. See? So now I'm going to add some tape to the glue tab L. Fold it over and make sure it sticks on top of the glue point. And you'll get something like this. Right. Now let's put this on top of the balloon. There's a part O, as you can see on the inside. Oh no, wait, there's no O, doesn't matter. Part O, glue point O, that's what you'll use for the basket. Make sure the part that sticks out is on top. I'm going to center it using this line as a guide. firmly push it, like so. All right, almost ready. Now, the last part I'm going to use for this. I think I lost a part. I can't find it. Where is it? All right, and I'm back. I found my piece. It was on the floor. Doesn't matter. I'm going to continue this. And what's important for this piece is that it makes this zigzag letter Z. I'm going to put tape on the end side. Like so. Going to carefully position that on the glue point. It's named N, like so. And now this part is a bit tricky, but I'm going to add some tape to the back of the M. Again, I'm doing this to hide the letters and instructions on the template. And now I'm going to help this a little bit by closing the card, folding flat the basket and push this down. So it will connect by itself and looks like this. You see? Now the last step is to add the basket part that also covers this a little bit better. Just going to put a little bit of tape on P, on the letter P. I'm going to align it with the top of this basket. Oh. All right. With this edge. Push it down like so. And it will look something like this. This way you cover the part below here. And that's it. That's how you make the hot air balloon. Now, this doesn't have a cover, and that's what we're going to add next. And for cover, I'm going to use a bit heavier paper. And I also have this wider double-sided tape that I'm going to use. I also have different scissors for tape. So I keep my scissors for paper exclusively for paper. Adding a little bit more tape here and there. I'm going to use my knife to get this off, like so. There's a bit of cat hair here, but that's what you got when you have cats. And now I'm going to carefully hold it shut as good as possible and align this page and carefully curl it up against that side. And now it's glued. All right, I'm going to cut off the paper that sticks out, like so. And you have a card that fully covers the balloon, like so. Now, to make this even stronger, I'm going to add a double-sided cover on the front. And I like to use double-sided covers because it makes the pop-up extra strong. And that way it also works better, especially when there's some tension going on. Like so. And with tension, I mean the pulling of the paper. The cover is the mechanism to make that happen, and that's why the cover, a stronger cover, works better. Right. As you can see, I'm using my knife to get these top sheets off the tape. Very simple, fast way to do this. Here's my other cover paper. Like so. And again, I'm going to cut this off. When you work with these knives, make sure they're sharp, otherwise break them off. You can break these parts off, but I think that's clear for everyone. So there it is, our popper balloon. And last thing you can do is use the decoration sheet that I have here to decorate the card. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut these out, fast forward in the video. Okay, and we're back. I've cut out all these decoration pieces. I chose to use the sun this time and a smaller balloon. And this piece I also prepared. This one came out of this one, as you can see. So I want this to be a bit taller. So I'm going to take an extra sheet of paper. And I'm going to position this here, somewhere there, and follow this line. And I'll have the same shape, but filled to the bottom, like so. All right, now we can assemble the details. And I'm going to start with this part first. I'm only putting tape on the bottom parts, so I can stick in different parts later. Maybe a little bit tape here, so it doesn't get too floppy. And a little bit of tape here. And I'm going to make sure this line gets hidden. You can also use this as an ocean horizon or anything, but I'm going to hide it. Like so, and going to put this part on top. And you can use different colors of paper for this, like in my example, or you can color it in using markers. But this is pretty easy to do. Right. And I like to see this as a lake or something. It's totally fine. I think that's a great way to see it. I also use that in my colored version. Those are mountains. I'm gonna put that in the background. Like so. Right. And then there's the sun. I think it's nice to have a sunset going on here. Whatever you do, don't glue anything on top of this vault. So when I'm going to put the sun in here, it needs to be either here or there or there. But I like to make it a sunset. So that's what I'm going to do. Putting some tape on the back and position it as high as possible, as long as it doesn't touch the vault there. Adding some trees. So as you can see, I can stick it very easily in these layers. That's what I'm going to do. Right. I'm going to flip this one. Like so. There are some trees. And I have a cloud left. This cloud. I'll put that one. Now let me see first what's nice to do. Yeah, I think this balloon is nice to put here and put a cloud on top here. Something like this. And the balloon. I could have also used this smaller balloon and put it here. That's all up to you. As you can see, this is sort of the landscape I made now. And that's also a variation on this landscape. I've used the same shapes from the template and cut it out in colored paper. All right, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. There's one more thing I would like to show you, and that's this ID. I personally didn't like it, but maybe some of you will say, why not attach strings to the balloon? It's possible, but I thought it came out a little bit messy, but it sort of works. So that's also a possibility. And I'm sure that when you're using colored paper, this also will look a lot better. So on something like this, I think the lines will stand out more, but that's up to you. So I hope you can use my template to make something beautiful, and make sure to share it with me, because I would love to see what you guys are going to make out of this. And again, I hope you'll enjoy building this and looking forward to see the results. Until next time, bye bye.